How to be a good charter, part one. Requirement one. Be able to calculate and find the BPM on your own. Without asking the original composer of the song. Without using any tools. Number three, be able to time correctly. So we are going to use Savodilla here as an example. This particular chart is the alt chart, is the one from the original mod. The audio files are also from the original mod. So without further ado, let's open and go into it. Let's start by playing it a bit and see if you can find what's wrong. Okay, have you found issues yet? If you haven't, I would not recommend you working on a mod team if you cannot spot the errors here. So, what is wrong with this chart? Well, let's open the chart editor and I'll show you. So, problem one. The chart is out of sync a lot. Problem number two, have you spotted it yet? It maybe helps if we put waveform to instrumental. Notice anything wrong? From this section to the next, and to the next, and to the next. If your answer was it's not tempo mapped, you are absolutely correct. This song, doesn't have the correct BPM value. So, what is the correct BPM value for this song? Well, then let's go into how you can count the BPM on your own. It's very, very easy most of the time. You should never have any troubles counting out and finding out the BPM. Like, this is the basics of charting. You need to be able to do this. Sure, you can ask tools as a second opinion or ask find answers on Google for a second opinion, but you should always count the BPM yourself first. So, okay, so to figure out the BPM, you first need to understand the basics of time signatures. Time signatures are how many measures there are in a beat. So in this case, and most case, almost every song you probably listen to is made in the time signature of 4x4. I'm not sure if you say 4x4 or 4/4, but anyways, time signatures work like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And that repeats all through the song. Some songs have changing time signatures. I can reveal to you already, this song doesn't, so we're skipping over this for this video. So now you know how 4x4 time signatures work. And most songs are created with 4x4. So to calculate the BPM, it's extremely easy once you understand the 1, 2, 3, 4 concept. Basically, the moment boyfriend's part starts here, we are going to tap. You can use a tool like this. It's very handy. And since it's not an automated tool, tools like this are fine to use when calculating BPM. So when boyfriend's part starts, I will start tapping here. And you'll notice something I do too, when I do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. See, this song has a BPM of 132. What has the original charter of this song put? They put 135. Which is incorrect. So if we change, remember how these lines are going further and further down? When we change the BPM to 132, it should always stay in the same place. And the next section should always start on the first measure. Or, I mean, on the first step. Starts instantly up here. Like that. So that's how you count BPM. Why might the person have used 135 though? Either they have no rhythm sense if they calculated the BPM on their own. Number two could be an automated tool. So let's say TuneBat is a popular one. Okay, it actually got it right. But in terms of automatic tools to calculate BPM, you should use Arrow Vortex program to do it. So if you're unsure about the BPM and want a second opinion, use Arrow Vortex. It has a great algorithm to find out the BPM, and it's almost never wrong. And it also finds different BPMs depending on changes and stuff on. Here's Savodilla. Again, find BPM. Boom. 100% correct. But many times, it will. If you're using Arrow Vortex chart and it sets the music offset to like something like this, 0.4. This is not needed and is pretty dumb. Just put this at zero. When it comes to FNF, the music offset is not needed because the first beat is at zero. So why it does 0.4, I have no clue. I think it tries to match the first beat on a snare hit, basically. So that's probably why it changes. but since like 0, 1, 2, 4, 3. So this is the first beat. So 0 here, here's one section in like in the short editor here. This is one section. This is another. That's how you calculate BPM. So why is this short so out of sync still? Well, that's because the shorter shorted it out of sync. So after you have calculated BPM, turn off the instrumental waveform and use the voice one. See how much better it sounds compared to before. This is perfectly on beat. I don't know how it is in Cade Engine, but in Psych Engine, this waveform is actually incorrect once you go above 4x zoom. Let me show you. So, correct. Starts, yeah, you see? This is not correct. So don't use 8th zoom in Psych, at least for now. When that gets fixed, feel free to. And that's how the short was before.